Welcome to my Procreate Beginner Series. Today we will learn how to paint with a sense of perspective. The technique of painting with perspective can be widely used in drawing sheer dresses, stockings, and other skirt outfits. The focus is on creating a lightweight texture. So let's first study the basic theory of perspective. So today, let's first study the basic theory of perspective. This is a transparent glass ball. You can see the clear contour edges and also see the background through the transparent parts. What's important is that the ball does not reveal the background colors completely. This is very important. This means we need to draw the contours of the ball, as well as paint the subtle partial transparency effect. That is very important in drawing fabric textures. So let's get started. He's white color. Studio pin. Draw circle. We have a white circle. As you can see, it doesn't have any transparent effect at all. To create a transparent effect, the key is to erase parts of the color to reveal the background color. This time, we will use an eraser. Just like brushes, erasers also have different types. This time, we are going to choose the soft brush, starting from the center of the ball. Choose an appropriate size. Slowly erase the color of the ball. If you feel that the erased edges are a bit harsh, you can use Gaussian blur to even. Now, you can see the white circle from before. I have erased the color except for the center. There's still some color left around the edges. This is because about 1/5 of the ball still retains some color. This is necessary to give it a subtle appearance. If this part is completely erased, it would be impossible to continue drawing other colors within the contour. So we've retained a portion of the color. Now create a new layer and turn on the clipping mask feature. We can choose a dark gray color. Select the airbrushing brush. Inside, choose soft airbrush. Begin to layer and draw the color on the edges. Okay, the edges are a bit harsh. Let's use Gaussian blur to adjust it. Good. Create a new layer between the two layers. This way, the clipping mask feature is automatically enabled. Now we can choose another color, a lighter shade of gray. This time, we can switch to a different brush. This time, we can choose a brush with a slightly grainy texture at the edges. Yeah. Choose the fat nozzle brush inside the spray pan. Choose an appropriate brush size. And layer by layer, render. In the middle, you can adjust the brush size according to your intention. Add new layers as needed to continuously render. Okay, now we need to add some white highlights. Still create a new layer. When you create any layers between the original or any layer and the first layer with the clipping mask enabled, they will all automatically have the clipping mask feature enabled. This time, we choose white. Still using white, we use the soft airbrush in the airbrush category. First, draw the highlight areas along the edge. To continue to create a new layer and turn on the clipping mask feature. We need to switch to a slightly whiter color. When the effect hasn't reached your desired look, you can keep adding new layers and continuously render until you achieve the final satisfying result. Okay, now we've drawn a transparent sphere. With both a sense of gloss and perspective, I hope today's video can help you. See you next time.